Hey guys, it's Tim with PT Progress, and today I'm going to show you how to use a TENS unit for pain relief and share my opinion as a physical therapist about this unit right here, a TENS and EMS unit from iRelief. So TENS stands for Transcutaneous Electrical Nerve Stimulation, and while that may sound complicated, it simply means that an electrical current is transmitted by pads which you adhere to your skin, and that can ultimately help to decrease pain through that electrical sensation. Now, these small electrical impulses through the pad sent through this TENS unit give kind of a tingling sensation to the skin, which essentially blocks the pain signal that's transmitted through the spinal cord into the brain. And this phenomenon is called gate control theory of pain, and it's commonly used in physical therapy for pain reduction, but it only works while you're using the machine. And for those of you who don't like to use pain meds you can't because an allergy or medical restrictions, TENS units, they're really great for pain relief. And if you've experienced that type of relief from a TENS unit in the past, let me know by hitting the like button below. Now that explains what the TENS unit does in general. And I'll show you how to use the machine in a second, but let's compare TENS to EMS because some units like this one right here give you an option for both. EMS stands for electrical muscle stimulation. And just like TENS, it delivers an electrical impulse, but instead of pulsating at just the skin level, EMS settings are meant for targeting your muscles to help with active recovery or to stimulate a muscle contraction, which can help to reduce swelling or even to promote muscle recovery. Now, if your doctor or PT recommended a unit like this to help with pain, you can simply focus on the TENS setting because we really don't want the muscles to contract if our goal is just to decrease pain. But on the flip side, EMS is great as an option to have if you're trying to decrease swelling or to promote muscle recovery after a workout or even muscle activation after a surgery. So there are great uses for both settings, and it's nice to have a machine that gives you both options all in one. Now, when you get your TENS unit like this one that I have here from iRelief, this is the wired version. There's also a wireless version. It's really easy to set up. All you gotta do is make sure it's charged and you have fresh pads, which it comes with some pads to connect to the unit and then onto your skin. Of course, a word of caution, you should not use a TENS unit or an EMS unit if you have a pacemaker or implanted electrical devices, a history of epilepsy, cardiac arrhythmias, or if you're pregnant. And even more, you should not use a TENS unit directly over the heart, the eyes, or the carotid artery on the neck, and avoid placing the pads on any damaged skin or fracture sites or on an area with known cancer. Okay, let's talk about placing these pads. Step one is to make sure that your skin is clear of any lotions or oils so that this pad with a sticky back can stick to that skin very easily. With this unit, we have an option for four pads to use or as a quad channel or even two pads as a dual channel. I typically use the two channels for smaller areas like the elbow and four channels for larger areas like your knee or your back or even your shoulders. And what you want to do is place the pads so that they surround the painful area. Now, this unit comes with four small pads and then also two large pads for covering a wider area. And when you're using two channels, place the pads on either side of the painful spot. When you're using four channels, use a cross pattern so the painful area is between those channels. If you have the wireless version, the setup is pretty much the same, but you don't have the wires to contend with, so you're free to move around and to be active and to be more discreet than having wires hanging off of you. It simply comes with a remote just like the original, but it has these pods that the pods connect to these pads, and you turn them on and they speak to each other, and you can increase it with the remote, and you'll feel the pulsating happen through the pads, which you just stick wherever you need. So you can have one pad over here and one pad over here and control it all with the same remote. Oh, and by the way, if you're finding this video to be helpful, let me know by hitting that like button and leaving a comment with any questions you have. I see all of your comments and I love to hear from you guys. All right, on to selecting the intensity. Remember, with TENS, we are not looking to get a muscular contraction. So the sensation should be more of a tingling feeling that is strong but comfortable. And on this unit here, you can control the intensity for each channel by using this remote. Just turn on the device by holding that top button here for 3 seconds, then press that center button to choose between modes, TENS and EMS, by clicking that plus or minus button. You'll see the screen flash between TENS for pain relief or EMS for muscle recovery. Press mode again to select that program, of which you have 14 different options to choose from, with descriptions of each of these options in the helpful guide that comes with this unit. Now finally, press mode again to set a timer for 15 to 20 minutes with a maximum of 60 minutes. And then repeat this throughout the day as long as you can comfortably tolerate wearing the device. You can wear a TENS unit while working or being active throughout the day. Of course, you'll want to make sure that your wires don't get snagged on things if you're moving around. The wireless version solves this issue, and while it's a bit more expensive than the wired option, you'll find that it's nice to be able to move around without wires and with less pain. Another great option is to pair the TENS unit with an ice pack for about 20 minutes. Just make sure you have a cloth barrier against your skin so that you don't burn your skin with an ice pack. These ice packs are also from iRelieve and they pair perfectly with the unit. All right, now let's take a look at how to use the EMS setting on a device like this. Remember, EMS stands for electrical muscle stimulation, so the current will be strong enough to make the muscles contract. This is beneficial for decreasing swelling because our body relies on our muscles to act as a pump to draw fluid back up to our heart and through the lymphatic system. Now, the muscular contraction will look something like this. I'm targeting the muscles on top of my thigh called the quadriceps muscles. With the device set on EMS, you can increase the intensity by selecting the channel and clicking the plus or minus buttons to select a strong but tolerable setting. The unit will send that current automatically so that your muscles contract and relax without any control from you. Now there are a lot of different settings on these units, and one of the reasons I recommend the iRelieve unit to my patients is because the instructions in the instruction manual are just so simple and easy to understand. They have helpful charts explaining each setting with clear recommendations on how to use the unit, and I'll use more videos in the future to go into detail on how to use a unit like this for specific issues like back pain or shoulder pain, but now you just have a good idea of how to set up this unit and why you would want to use the TENS or select the EMS setting based on your goals to decrease pain or reduce swelling or even promote muscle recovery. You can find this exact unit that I'm using in the description below, and be sure to subscribe to the channel for more helpful videos on how to make the most of your device. Hey, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.